One element of Scottish culture which unites the whole of the country is tartan. Originally used to differentiate families or clans, it's now seen everywhere. At this year's North Berwick's International Highland Games, pipe bands from 15 countries met in a celebration of Scottish and Celtic culture. All of the band members proudly wearing the traditional tartan.
So the tartan I'm wearing is the Royal Stewart Tartan. Not sure when it was invented or anything like that, but it's the most popular tartan for Highland bands and other Highland descended people.
Tartan has been worn since the 1700s and is still as popular as ever. In 2008, international designers Dolce & Gabbana presented a collection which may have looked more at home on the lawns of Balmoral Castle than a catwalk in Milan. Historically, the tartan was the everyday wear of Highlanders, spun, dyed, woven and fashioned locally. On Edinburgh's Royal Mile, numerous shops sell tartan dresses, kilts and hats to local Scots and international tourists. While many customers choose a style solely based on colours and designs, for Scots it means much more.
Originally, a tartan was something that was quite simple. It was a check, and it was something that would be hand-woven and it would be dyed using vegetation. So originally, you actually knew where somebody was from because of where they lived and what their vegetation comprised of. It's a matter of being proud of wearing the tartan because it symbolises where you're from. It shows that you're proud of being Scottish, and it sort of shows you your heritage in terms of your family roots.
During the Industrial Revolution, production methods transformed tartan from Highland wear to a commercially viable product. Victorian Britain's love affair saw tartan incorporated into a more formal style of dress.